video, we'll look at deploying the Mistral model using a no-code approach. If you're not already familiar, Mistral is a very popular LLM provider, and we'll be taking one of their smaller models and deploying it on Vertex AI. Vertex AI is part of the Google Cloud platform. While there's a lot more in the Google Cloud suite than just the Vertex AI service, we're going to focus on that today to show you the simplest way to deploy your own Mistral API. We're starting with a fresh project. The first thing we want to do is go to the Vertex AI page and enable all the recommended APIs. Next, let's go to the model garden and find the Mistral model. There's a quick deploy button, and we'll be going with the Vertex AI approach as opposed to Kubernetes. Kubernetes gives you the ability to spin this up using an ML PyTorch container, which can be handy if you're already familiar with Kubernetes. But the most turnkey way to go is to use Vertex AI, and we're going to do a one-click deployment here. Note that it's going to use two L4 GPUs to back this deployment. We're going to deploy to US Central 1. The deployment could take a while, but once the model is deployed, we should be able to head down to the deployed models portion of Vertex AI and check out the model deployment. We can see that we have our active model here, and we can click into details to see more information. It even gives us an interface for sample requests. Let's go ahead and give this API a try using that example request. We've also got this model in the model registry where we can test it out even more easily. However, for more production-like testing, let's use the API directly via an API call. First, let's set the environment variables that we need. You can just grab them from the setup here. These will be used in our curl call. We just need to know what endpoint and project we're using. Next, we need an example JSON file that looks like this. This can be a pretty simple file. We don't really need any parameters for this model, just a prompt, a number of responses, and a max token value. Here's an example parameterization, which I pulled directly from the models page in the model garden. Let's go ahead and try out our response here. This is just a standard HTTP call, and we use that example.json file. Hopefully we have our story here. Indeed, we get a story that starts with once upon a time and fits within our token limits. We now have our own Mistral API that's live and ready for our use, privately in our Google Cloud project. We hope that this video was helpful. Thank you very much for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.